Welcome to Acoustic Spotlight, the program that features performers of acoustic music. I'm your host, Rich Pietrzak. Today's spotlight falls on a songwriting duo from Orlando, Florida, Mark and James.
Got a thousand reasons to love you. Got a thousand miles to stay away. Got a thousand miles between us now. Gets less with every step we take.
Welcome back to the show. I'm here with Mark and James. Welcome to the program, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
Now, for our audience's sake, which one is Mark and which one's James?
I'm Mark over here.
James.
We try to keep it left to right and make it easy.
Yeah. All right. So you don't confuse yourself.
Right. It happens from time to time. I look at pictures, James will be on the left, and it's like, who is that?
I don't know the person.
I thought that was me. Yeah.
We keep Ampersand in the middle.
Yeah, he usually sits here. So. Could be a she, I don't know.
Well, Well, I enjoyed that first tune, and I really like your harmonies.
Thanks.
Well,
thank you very much.
Yeah. As far as your songwriting goes, how do you guys handle that?
A lot of times, well, according to the U.S. Copyright Office, it's
50% of everything.
Yeah. But, you know? But, you know, sometimes depending on, like, if he's feeling more inspired about something, he'll write, you know, an entire song, or I'll write an entire one, and the other one will jump in at, you know, 90% of the process, mm-hmm. and you know, put their piece in. And then other times, like, we've literally played leapfrog.
Which is, like, I'll write a line, and then I'll be like, all right, your turn, write a line. And it kind of makes, maybe for, like, a bipolar-type song, but
really?
It works. Yeah. And we just try to experiment with just different styles and see what works best for us and whatever.
Yeah. Have you done many, you know, yourselves, just individually?
Yeah, I mean, before we started playing together, we had each written a few songs and, you know, just kind of put them together and then took what we had before as well and just said, all right, James, I need help with, you know, a bridge, whatever, help me out.
Yeah.
Make it better.
And a lot of times, I mean, a lot about, like, what makes us is that, like, we are two different people. So it's really, it's always cool, at least in songwriting, especially, like, you know, he's going to start somewhere and bring it to me and, you know, and I might go somewhere completely different with it, you know, and it's really always good to have someone there to get another angle on it, especially one that's usually vastly different.
Sure. So. Yeah, and you had to bounce things off.
Right.
Of, yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, how long have you guys known each other?
We actually met at University of Central Florida our freshman year in college, 2004.
In a hurricane shelter, actually. We didn't really feel like going home, I guess, for three or four hurricanes came through that year. So
it's like your parents are calling, they're like, we need help boarding up the house. And it's like, Mom, I'm going to stay here. I need to meet friends.
Yeah.
So
I shamelessly actually went to meet girls.
How'd that work out?
Failed miserably, if you want to know the truth. No, my friend's like, oh, meeting hot girls at shelter. I was like, yeah.
Met this awesome guy, Mark.
Yeah, great. But
he's got a good personality, though.
Good musician. But it was cool because we were just walking around with guitars. You know, I think I brought a pillow and a guitar to the shelter. And a week later, you know, we just started kind of jamming together. And that
played
kinda,
a show like 2 weeks later.
Yeah, 2 weeks later we played a show.
So,
and then the rest has just been.
I mean, we say show, though, like it's not like House of Blues or anything back then. It was like, you know, little coffee shops.
Yeah.
Right. So
right. Open, it felt like House of Blues back
show.
Then.
Oh, yeah, it was huge. I mean, yeah, girls throwing stuff at you. Different.
Now, but I understand you have done a House of Blues tour.
Yeah, we did. Yeah. Believe it was last summer, actually. We got to get out on the road. And really, for us, we got to host the show and we got to open it with a couple songs. And we got to skip the whole van stage and go right to the bus, which is really
you're
cool.
You're hanging out on the bus, you're watching movies, you got the internet, you're playing Halo, you're doing, I mean, it's ridiculous, but.
How many stops were on that?
I think we did like 26, maybe 27.
26 in like 30-something days.
Yeah, it was basically every day you were doing something, so.
Oh, it was a great experience.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it was awesome.
Yeah. I was looking at a bio and I saw some of the shows that you had performed with people like Avril Lavigne was mentioned, I think, in Matchbox 20. But one of the ones that struck out to me was Eddie Money. I'd seen you had opened moved to the opening spot for that. Yeah.
We played with Eddie Money.
Yeah.
I don't remember that show.
No,
I'm just kidding. That one was in Daytona. That was an odd show.
Yeah.
It wasn't exactly, you know, when you're playing a show, you try to make sure that you're a fit for their audience and everything, obviously, because you don't want to get booed off the stage.
We didn't.
But sometimes we'll try to cater our music selection of our songs to that audience. And that one just, it really wasn't winning with that show. Yeah.
Well, it's funny because I'm actually from Daytona Beach. It's where we played. Right. And so my mom came out with all of her friends. And usually my parents, you know, the people we opened for, they'll watch us play and then they're like, all right, we got to peace out. You know, they don't like that. But, like, Eddie Money, they were there the whole night dancing. And actually, at one point, I was like, who is that crazy woman dancing over there? I was like, that's my mom. Cool.
That's funny. Yeah, because I know, I mean, you guys are relatively young. I'm sure, you know, Eddie Money was popular before you were even born.
Right.
Because I liked Eddie Money. And,
right.
And didn't really listen to him anymore. I don't even know if he does make new records. But
I think so, maybe.
I don't know. I don't really have an educated guess on that one.
I can't verify that.
I heard some I knew, but
maybe it was real popular.
Take me home. So.
Yeah, take me home tonight.
Two tickets to paradise.
Yeah.
Well, let's get back to you guys, and how about doing another song?
Oh yeah,
oh,
definitely. This next one's called "Best I Never Had." So.
All right. Well, we'll be right back after this message with another song from Mark and James here on Acoustic Spotlight.
Step, I'll leave. There'll be no regrets, and I can't be sad. 'Cause you're the best I never had. So go, take your biggest step, I'll leave. There'll be no regrets, and I can't be sad. 'Cause you're the best I never had. 'Cause you're the best I never had. 'Cause you're the best I never had.
We're back with Mark and James. Another good tune.
Thank you very much.
The vocals, a little reminiscent to me of, do you remember the Gin Blossoms?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I mean, not like way before our time, but I think I was in like middle school. But yeah, no, they're good. I like Gin Blossoms.
Yeah, it sounded really good.
Thanks, man.
Do you have, obviously, musically, you played before, you knew each other and had those kinds of influences. But now that the time that you've been together, have you, studied or listened to any duos or harmonies that you kind of...
Not exactly. I mean,
I think duo, like I go back to Simon and Garfunkel, Hall & Oates, and I don't know where the duos went. Like, I say it's time to bring them back.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I wouldn't say there's ones we study. We definitely, I think, another thing about what makes this us is, like, he has his influences and I have mine, and they're left and right field, but we bring them together and it makes something new.
Right. Yeah. And it sounds great together.
Thanks. So, thank you.
Well, who are some of your influences individually?
I've been a big Ryan Cabrera fan for a while. Johnny Cash, One Republic, and I go to the rap side as well and just... My iPod's kind of like a community iPod,
a little bit.
Yeah. But.
I really, really like John Mayer a lot, John McLaughlin, Jason Mraz, so singer-songwriters type thing. One Republic's really good. I think we can agree on One Republic.
The Fray.
Right.
So. Yeah.
Right. How about as far as your I don't want to say classical training, but just your musical training? Did you start playing when you were both really young? Or?
I started guitar at 14. Once again, to pick up chicks. it's a recurring theme. And I played guitar through, well, obviously till now. In college, I decided I was going to take some music theory classes to better myself musically. That was a mistake because that was the two hardest classes I took in college, but made it through. I got B's, so I guess I'm an okay musician.
Yeah. I mean, I started playing the acoustic probably when I was 16 or so, and piano a couple years ago, and just more self-taught, for both of us. And singing, I went from being like the shy kid that had to go door to door in the girls' dorm room just to my friends would be like, all right, you got to sing in front of people. And I was like, dude, I can't do it. I'm so shy.
I feel like they were like using you.
They really were.
They're like, no, listen to our friends sing. Hey, what's up?
I'm like, so to meet people, so I could build up my confidence, I had to go door to door in the dorm room. We'd knock on the door and there'd be like four girls and like, hey, can we sing for you? And I'm like, no, please no. So, but I mean, it worked.
Yeah.
So now it's.
So you haven't had any vocal, training or anything like that?
Not really. I mean, I did a little choir when I was a kid. I guess everybody did.
Yeah.
We've had a couple lessons here and there, but.
Yeah, nothing. Yeah.
For the most part.
Well, you sound great.
Thank you.
Yeah, both very talented guys.
Thanks. So.
We're trying.
Yeah. You've got, and you have a record that was not a record anymore, I guess. A recording that's going to be coming out. And it's called Hello, I Love You and Goodbye.
Well, that one's actually out right now. You can grab that on iTunes. I think there's a few select stores carrying it. We have an online merch store also, which you can get to through markandjames.com. But that is a full acoustic album, and we have up and coming a full band album.
Right.
Because we're moving that direction.
Yeah, most of the bigger shows we've played have been full band,
band.
Drums, keyboard, bass, all that stuff. So it's what we're working on right now.
Well, it's always great to get to play acoustic stuff and to have the acoustic album because that's really how we started.
Right.
It was just me and
it's
him.
It's our roots.
Right.
Back to the roots.
Yeah. And imagine too when you're just in your composing and writing, you're probably going in that method. So,
yeah. Definitely.
How about as far as the families are concerned, they've been supportive of you?
Now they are. I mean, it's funny, like, freshman year of school, I'm going to college, I'm skipping class all the time to play guitar. Mom, I want to be a rock star. One time she actually came and took away, like, all my stuff, except she left me my guitar, which was nice of her, but she took away, like, my TV and all this other stuff. It's because I wasn't going to class. Little did she know it was because of music. And after your parents see you, on tour or on stage in front of like 8,000 people, like they changed their tune a bit, So now they're really supportive now. And they've always been really supportive of me as a person and musically. I mean, I couldn't ask for better parents.
I'd say for the most part, my parents the whole way through, from playing open mics to this and that, like they've been there all the time. So
that's great.
That's really good. And then, obviously it's like, other family members, like extended family, they're like, so what are you going to do when you grow up? And you're like, I want to be a rock star. And then it's almost like, you can't do that. Like,
your brother's a
nobody
pastor.
Nobody does that. Yeah, well, my brother, one of them, you know, went to seminary. The other one, talking about going to either med school or seminary. And then it's like, he plays music. But, you know.
Middle child syndrome.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, if people want to see you out and about, is there a website that they can go to?
Yeah, www.markandjames.com. Right now, it's kind of a portal to all of our other sites because we have MySpace, Facebook, iMeme, YouTube. But if you go to markandjames.com, you can get to all those places from there. Mm-hmm.
Okay,
and
great.
iTunes also. So.
Right.
How about one more tune?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I believe you want to play Letting Go?
Let's do it.
All right, man.
All right. Well, thanks for coming down, guys.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Oh, yeah, sure. And we'll be right back with one more from Mark and James here on Acoustic Spotlight.
This is my UCF.
Well, that's our program for today. We'd like to thank Mark and James for stopping by, and thank you for tuning in. Mark and James are going to do one more, and then we'll see you next time on Acoustic Spotlight.
And you make it so easy when you're here. Make me the person that I can't stand. And I'm running away from you. Bam-bam. With all these feelings, I never seem to run and hide. But I'm here and there, and I never felt so far away. I guess it's my turn to say I'm letting go. Someplace I did not foresee. Letting go.
I hope it was good. Did you really think you could hide from me?
That's alright, I'll be fine.
When you're done trying to live this fairy tale,
I've realized what you did just cost you me. And you make it so easy when you're here. You make me the person that I can't stand. I'm running away from you. And I know that I'll be just fine. But you're not around. Just leave me like you always do. But know that what you said to me is coming back around to you. Back around to you. So easy when you're here. You make me the person that I can't stand. I'm running away, I'm running away from you. I know that I'll be just fine. You're not around, just leave me like you always do. You know that what you said to me is coming back around to you. It's 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 coming back around to you. And you make it so easy when you're here. Make me the person that I can't stand.
running away. I'm running away from you, and I'll be just fine.
You know I'll be. You're never gonna go.
And I'll be just fine. And I know that I'll be just fine when you're not around, just sleeping like you always do. You know that what you sent to me is coming back around to you. Coming back around to you.